By rejecting the null, we know that at least two of the foods differ in terms of mean amount consumed. But we don't know which ones differ. We can see that all three of the means differ from each other, but we don't know if these differences are due to sampling error. Therefore, we need to do additional testing to see which means are different. This additional testing is called multiple comparison tests. So we're able to compare all of the means with each other. We wouldn't do a multiple comparison test until after we've done ANOVA. One of the most common multiple comparison tests is called Tukey's HSD, which stands for Honestly Significant Difference. It's named after John Tukey, a very influential statistician. Tukey's HSD evaluates the significance of the difference between any two group means. In statistics, we say that this test will allow us to make pairwise comparisons. The way we calculate Tukey's HSD is just like the margin of error that you've learned before. Remember that with a z-test, it was the z-critical value, denoted z-star, times the standard error. And remember with a t-test, it was the t-critical value times the standard error. But now when we're comparing three or more samples, we have a new statistic called q. And we multiply this by the square root of the mean square for within subject variability divided by n. You might ask, how is this similar to these? Well, the mean square for within subject variability is the pooled variance. It's just the average square deviation of each value from its respective group mean. Therefore, the square root is the pooled standard deviation. Q is the studentized range statistic. And we find this in yet another table. Its purpose is to adjust the whole HSD so that it's less likely we commit a type 1 error. Remember, a type 1 error is when we reject the null hypothesis when it's actually true. Since Q increases when there are more groups that we're comparing, it makes it less likely to commit a type 1 error. Remember that if a sample mean was further away from the population mean than the margin of error, it was considered unlikely? Well, if two sample means are further apart than the Tukey's HSD, then that's considered honestly significantly different.